All right, today's project, engineered air burner replacement. Let's get to this. Okay, so let's give you guys a quick rundown on how this operates before we change it. Main gas comes in. We have it teed off right here, and this is our main gas train. Where we tee off, this is our pilot line. So we have a shutoff there, and we have the gas valve there that, when opens, gives gas to the pilot assembly, which is right here. Once that pilot assembly is lit, flame is proven, now we can open up the main gas valve. This valve here modulates gas flow into the burner to keep the discharge air temperature constant. Okay, so that's why we need this modulating gas valve. And this basically steps down our gas pressure to the appliance pressure. So let's get started and get this changed out. Gas valve off, obviously. Okay, there is the union, which is cracked and undone. Now we have to disconnect all the wiring, undo some screws back in there, and this whole thing just slides right out. Very, very easy. Now this unit is still running. We've isolated the heating section from power. It has to stay running because it's for a laboratory. It's very critical that it stays running. So we've isolated the heating section. We're gonna work on this while the machine is still running. Now that we have the burner out, we're just gonna clean all this area up, get all that dirt out of there. The other thing is that we should be having a look at the heat exchanger. Now, I already looked inside here. I can't see any cracks or holes or anything like that. But one thing that we need to keep in mind is that we're starting to see some rust, okay? And we're starting to see some areas where the moisture has been collecting. This heat exchanger could get replaced very, very soon the way it looks, but right now, it does seem okay. All right, so we're getting places here. The new burner is in, okay? Union, we gotta tighten that up. This plate's been all tightened, so we're all fastened in. I'm going to put new connectors on these, and I also cut out the old pilot tubing that runs from inside here down to the gas valve, and I'm going to run new tubing and put on new fittings as well, so we're going to get that done right now. All right, new connections are in place. Brand new tubing, brand new fittings. With these, you just want to give them a tug. Just make sure that they're in there nice and tight. Same with the connections here. Just give them a pull, make sure they're in nice and tight. This tube here goes for the pilot. It's the air basically for the pilot that comes from the motor up here just to give the pilot some air. So we're gonna go ahead, put the cover back on this, fire it up. There's a spot right here where we can check gas pressure. We're gonna hook up our manometer there and check the performance and the gas pressure of this burner. Okay, we're all back together. We have the 510 ready to rock and roll. The mode we're in right now is dehumidification mode, meaning the compressors run to cool the evap coil. We cool that coil down, we remove moisture from the air, but if the air gets too cold going downstairs to overcool the space, we reheat the air back up, and that's what this burner and heating section is for in dehumidification mode. So we're just waiting for this to kick in. We'll check the pressure, we'll make sure it's modulating and keeping the temp downstairs the way it should, and I think we're done with this little job here. All right, so we're up and running here, and I know it's really hard to see through there, but we can see the burner all fired up. Tried to clean this as best I could, but I think it needs a new glass. It won't clean. We are at 0.24 inches, okay? And like I said, this is a modulating gas valve. It's not full bore. It modulates up and down to feed the correct amount of gas to the burner, bring the air up to the right temperature. So we have it set for around 70 degrees. It tries to maintain 70 degrees discharge air after the cooling coil going to the lab downstairs. So that's it, guys. The burner's changed. It's running. This is pretty good. I'm gonna go check the discharge air at the computer. That's my last step, and we're done. Happy HVACing.